Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple finally announced iOS 18. iOS 18 Beta 1 is out to developers, it will be out to public beta testers in July, and usually out to the public in mid-September around the next iPhone launch. Now in this video I'll cover all the major changes. I won't go into depth like I will in a future video where we cover every single little change, but in this one we'll go over just the major changes. Now the overall update size was around 7 gigabytes. On my iPhone 15 Pro Max it was 7.11 gigabytes. As far as supported devices, well the good news is it supports everything iOS 17 did, from the iPhone XR to the iPhone XS all the way up to the iPhone 15 Pro and 15 Pro Max and of course iPhone 16 in the future. Now, features may not be on all the devices, but in general, it will get all of the major changes. And there is something Apple announced today called Apple Intelligence. That will be available to developers later this summer, so it's not available on any devices yet, but that particular update will only be on iPhone 15 Pro and 15 Pro Max, iPhone 16 models, and basically any device with an M1 or later processor, including iPad and Mac. Now, of course, Apple released a ton of updates along with this. We'll cover those in separate videos as well, but let's jump right into the new features. So if we swipe home, nothing looks too different so far at all. However, Apple is now giving us the ability to rearrange the home screen how we'd like. So maybe we want to, let's go into a new home screen here, and maybe we'll open a new one, press and hold. We'll go to here, and let's just start a new one. We'll add this, and now we can add some apps. So maybe I want this one over here. I want Safari up here. I can place them wherever I'd like. If I want them in a grid, I can do that. If I want to put Safari back, I can do that. So you can now place icons wherever you'd like. So if you don't want to sort of cover up the entire thing, you don't have to. And you can also see I can resize widgets just like that. Grab the little handle in the bottom right, and then I can just pull and resize a widget. We also have an option to change the overall icon size. Tap the little edit icon, go to customize, and now we have a bunch of options for automatic, dark mode, light mode, and tinted for all of the icons. We can change the overall icons to a larger size, change them back to their normal or small size, and like I said, we can change them from automatic to dark mode to light mode or tinted. If we go in, you'll see we have a new control center. We'll talk about that in a moment, but if we turn on dark mode, now all of the icons change if you want them to, fully customizable to a dark mode icon that goes along with this new iOS 18 wallpaper. That carries across to older devices as well. So we'll scroll down. Again, we'll cover the control center in a moment, but you get that on all of the devices. So this isn't limited to anything else. It's on all of them. And again, we can change them if we don't want them to be this color. Let's go here. We'll edit and we'll customize again. And then maybe we'll tint the icons to whatever we'd like. So maybe we want them to be this color. We can do that. Change the different color here. However we'd like, we want to leave them tinted. That's fine. Go back and everything's tinted. So you can fully customize this however you'd like. I prefer the actual dark mode, I think. And I'll try that out a little bit, but we'll just switch it back to automatic. Or dark, automatic, there we go. And it is a little bit buggy, as it is an early beta, but in general, you can see it switches back and forth. And again, we can arrange these however we'd like. If we want to get rid of some of these, move these over here, and just have a few that are down the side, I can just move these around, get rid of this one, and you can have it just how it always has been, or arrange it however you'd like. You also have the option to lock apps now. This is something I know a lot of people have wanted, and to do that, all you do is press and hold on an app. So here is X or Twitter, and all we need to do is require Face ID, and then it says require Face ID or hide and require Face ID. You can hide your apps into a hidden folder or just require Face ID. So now if I want to go into it, it's going to ask for that. So we'll go into Twitter or X. Now it's going to require it, and now I'm in. So it opens up just like that. The same is true again, if I want to hide an app, just press and hold, then we can require Face ID, and specific apps it won't let you hide, but other apps, third-party apps, it will. So if we go in and maybe we want to hide Google Maps, require Face ID, hide and require, there we go, and it says hide Google Maps, obscured app name and icon, and no app notifications or calls. So if you want to do that, you can just hide it like that, it goes away. And then if we go back over, scroll down, we have hidden apps down at the bottom of our app library. Tap on it, and then you can see it as long as you can verify with your Face ID. That works with Touch ID, and it's great to have that finally in the OS overall. The Control Center gets a major update as well. In the Control Center, you'll see everything is sort of rounded now, and if we press and hold, we can edit that way or just tap the plus in the upper left. I can resize the different things just with the same handle in the bottom right, can change it that way, move it back over here, and you'll see it is a little bit buggy, but if I want to change things, make it a little bit bigger, I can do that. If it has a little resizable thing there on the side for orientation lock, you can resize this however you'd like, change it however you'd like, and then add a control. So we have a whole different control center area here where we can go in and then sort of browse everything in our control gallery. You'll see connectivity, it's a little bit choppy, focus modes, hearing accessibility, home, motor accessibility. Everything that we have here, we can add right to our control center. So lots of things, a much easier way to add these into the control center. So you'll see that we also have pages for it. So if we want to just scroll down, we can scroll through and go right to whatever we like the most. So that gets us in there, goes in quickly, and then just swipe up and it locks in place. We also have our power button in the control center here in the upper right, or a little add button here. So we can quickly add or power off our device if we want to. Now, if we lock our device, go onto the home screen or the lock screen, we have our icons in the bottom left, and we can finally change these in iOS 18. Press and hold. So let's unlock, press and hold, or we'll swipe up, go back in, press and hold. And then if we go to customize, customize lock screen, you'll see we have the icons in the bottom right and bottom left. So everything else here is pretty much the same with the exception of the new iOS 18 wallpaper. There was a rumor that we would get more. Maybe we'll see that later on. But if we tap the little minus button there and then add something else, again, this is a little bit buggy, but we can add specific controls to the lock screen. So if we want our alarm, we could add that. If we want to get rid of the camera, we could add something else. So we could add maybe motor accessibility buttons or our remote for our Apple TV. Press done, and now it locks it in place. Let's clear our notifications, and you'll see them here. Press and hold, and we jump right into them. So again, press and hold, we're right into our alarms. The Photos app gets a major update and a full redesign. Our photos are up here at the top. We have recent days, people and pets, and we have the option to search with more context or more natural language. We could search for something such as a camera or something that it's recommending here, camera. You'll see here, text found, and it's just a little bit of an overview or a change of what you actually have. If I scroll down, as I scroll down, you've got pinned collections with your memories, we've got trips, and then albums, shared albums, and more. So you have all of the things you typically have, and your hidden and duplicates and more, and then different wallpaper suggestions. So it's been fully redesigned with more customization, and there's a lot of different changes throughout that are coming with Apple Intelligence or Apple's AI. However, that's not available just yet. There are major changes to go through here as well, but I just wanted to cover the big ones other than every little detail. Now the phone gets a pretty big update, but some of it's not available yet. If we go into the phone app, within the phone app, if we just start typing, it will now bring up suggestions like we've wanted for a long time. If I type 1 and then 800, you'll see it brings up suggestions as I type. We'll also have the option to record phone calls, and it will live transcribe them. This does not appear to be available yet. I don't see options for it yet, but Apple actually mentioned it on their iOS 18 webpage and also within the keynote for WWDC. So this is something that's definitely coming. It will notify them when you start recording the call, and I know many people have wanted this, and I thought it was something Apple would never add. Now we have an all new app this time around as well. The rumors were right about this, and if we keep going here, if I can find it, maybe I've already passed it here. Let's see if I can locate it. We have a new passwords app. So let's see where it is. It's up in the upper left. If we go into that, we've got a passwords app that's locked with your password, and it's just to easily manage all of your passwords, similar to what you have with 1Password. It has secure encryption, seamless syncing across your devices. If we go to continue, we can turn on notifications, allow, and now you can see all of your passwords. We can search for them, share them, and it's just a much easier way to actually view these instead of going into settings. And speaking of settings, settings gets an update as well. It's not a huge update. It looks pretty familiar here, but if we scroll down, it ends pretty quickly. That's because Apple's moved everything into apps that relates to apps, both Apple apps and other third-party apps. Another major update has to do with Safari. If we go into Safari, at the Apple website, we now have an option to show highlights. So if we tap on the button here, it says highlights. We can turn this on. Using Safari, it will intelligently display summaries, previews, and suggestions from the web, nearby locations, and more. We'll turn that on, and then also we have a new reader view. And if we go into our Safari settings and we scroll down, see if we can find it, we have an option for highlights. So that should be available. Let's try a different website and see if it works. So we'll go to Mac Rumors. We'll go to the main one here from today and see if it does anything. So we'll go in and there's some highlights. It says show reader. We can listen to the page. So those are a little bit easier to see. And that's our new reader view. So some major changes here. It's also supposedly much faster on the Mac, but I'll have to try that out. Now, Messages get some updates as well. Many people will be happy that we finally have RCS messaging. That's been added directly to Messages. If we go into Messages, within Messages, if we type a new message, tap on the plus to the left, scroll down, we have the option to schedule a message and send it later. So we have a little dial. Maybe I want to send this tomorrow at maybe 1 p.m. and it'll go ahead and send. So we'll just tap send and it says send later, Wednesday at 1 p.m. Eastern time. So that's when it will actually send and it's good to go. Of course, you could get rid of it if you want to change that, but you actually have the option to send messages later finally or schedule them. You can also highlight text. So this is a new message. And then maybe I want to highlight this area here, maybe the word message itself. And then we have the option if we slide over to go into text effects, and then we can change the text itself. Big, small, shake, nod, you'll see the different options here. So maybe we'll just make it go into explode and then we'll send. And you'll see it will do that here. It sends and then jumps off the page. So that's great. We have that option. And then we also have new tap back options. So if we press and hold, you'll see that they're colored now. They look a little bit different. And we have the option to add any reply with any emoji we want. So you can use any emoji instead of just a few. So if we want to do that again, tap add emoji, we can select whatever we'd like just by searching through our emoji. Another feature we'll have that may not work 100% yet is the new option to use messages via satellite with iMessage or RCS. This will allow you to use a phone that has the satellite functionality to actually message someone directly within there using satellite connectivity when you don't have cell or Wi-Fi. So that's a great update, and I can't wait to actually use that when I'm in an area with no signal. There's some mail updates that are coming later. They did show off that they're redoing this a little bit, but we haven't seen a whole lot with it. There's also a new game mode that's going to be built into iOS 18, and that game mode allows it to reduce background activity to maximize performance. AirPods and game controllers are also more responsive with less lag, so that's something that will be available once iOS 18 launches and games support it. Journaling gets an update as well. You can now add a state of mind directly into a journal entry, so you can enable that. Can turn it on to use state of mind. We'll turn on all of them for our journaling app, go back, and then it allows us to add a state of mind when we're making a new entry. So if you want to do that and just start writing, this is WWDC 2024. And then you can write here. And again, you can add a state of mind with this icon here, and you have to allow it in your health access data. There we go. And then we can add it. So add how you're feeling right at that time of journaling. There'll also be new insights based on how often you journal. You'll see here, entry this year, words written, days journaled, not very much. I haven't really used it, but it's there. And then you'll be able to easily find past entries with search if you have a bunch of those, and based on photos and videos and everything else. And you'll see the overall home screen has been updated as well. Now, the big change that we aren't seeing just yet is Apple Intelligence. Siri will look completely new, and if I activate it, you'll see that it's not really different at all. So the overall Siri look isn't different, but if we go to Apple's website and if we scroll down, you'll see Apple Intelligence. And again, this is coming a little bit later, but there's an all new Siri that's activated that sort of surrounds the device and then uses different artificial intelligence to create images, create different things based on what you need, based on context, even sort of look at your text and give you suggestions, and it's all done on device. So this is something that's coming a little bit later and also integrating with ChatGPT-4 if you want to for free, but you have to opt in and allow it every time it wants to leave your device. So you could even circle an image here and it will create an image on its own or find one that's better than what you actually drew if you want to use that maybe in a presentation. Lots of really impressive things here, and we need to deep dive into that, and it's not available just yet even to developers. So lots of different changes. There's many more small changes throughout, and we're still finding more and more. Just like when you activate the flashlight on the lock screen, you'll see we have an all new animation. Lots of other things to actually go in and sort of figure out what's going on and what's all new. And as I've done that, I'll just make another video and of course talk about that in depth. If you found anything else that stand out, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below, and I'll try and link the all new iOS 18 wallpapers in the description if you want to try them for yourself and you're not trying the beta. And if you're wondering if you should install iOS 18 beta 1, I would definitely hold off. My phone is very hot right now. It's sort of laggy going through different things. It's an early beta, just like all the other early betas, but hopefully it's much more stable as time goes on. But again, let me know your favorite feature in the comments below. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.